Please welcome Lena Dunham.
Welcome.
Pleasure to be here. Thank you.
It's great to have you on the show. We've been talking about cars. Do you drive yourself?
I mean, you mean do I drive myself or do I?
Yeah. Do you drive?
No.
Both.
No, I don't. I don't know how to do that.
It's not difficult.
But it is for some people. I've found it tremendously challenging. I'm so impressed that you can even wrap your mind around anything about cars beyond turning the key. I found it really hard.
So you have tried?
Yeah, I took driver's ed. I don't know if you guys call it that here. We call it driver's education in the United States. And I took it for 8 months. And I failed the test twice. And I decided that, you know, some people aren't meant to be mothers and some people aren't meant to drive. But
I wasn't meant to be a mother, you're quite right.
But then men specifically always say, oh, I could teach you how to drive, as if just like their particular style of driving will change my entire life. But no one can teach me how to drive. It's my special talent.
Do you think that's right, that some people shouldn't have a license?
No, that's definitely true. I'm not saying that about you necessarily because I don't know you very well yet.
I'm saying that about me.
Okay. I quite like the idea that you think nobody could teach you to drive. I'd see the beginnings of an excellent TV series because obviously it would be a long one, wouldn't it?
I mean, many men have tried and many men have failed to teach me how to drive, starting with my father, several boyfriends, several instructors, and no one's nailed it yet.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Oh, you seem the most qualified by far.
He's very qualified. I mean, he can drive almost anything. He can teach you to fly.
Well, he can drive almost anything. He has that sophisticated accent. He kissed my hand. He's definitely the right candidate for the job.
This is good, isn't it? Oh. Thank you.
Promise me to pick up this letter, right?
Yeah, okay.
I mean, you're right, there would be a good show about it, but let's just make it a show about us too.
Are you a good passenger?
Yeah, because I have no opinions. I don't know anything about driving. I don't have any opinions. You could drive into a lamppost and I'd go, you're an amazing driver.
Lena, your television series, Girls.
Yes.
It's very popular also in Scandinavia.
That's so exciting to me because Scandinavian people are popular with me.
Especially now. It's been called the Sex in the City for our day and age, but to me the message is very different.
Yeah.
Do you agree?
I think that Sex in the City, you know, made way for women in television, women, you know, behaving badly on television. I absolutely love the show. I think that one difference about our show is it's takes place post financial recession, so it's about a different New York, a less glamorous New York, a New York where you kind of, you know, have to live in a closet or get out of there, and then you don't have a closet, you live in a closet. And also, I think that Sex and the City is about a different time in a woman's life. I mean, these women were already set in their careers and they were sort of trying to figure out their families and men, whereas our characters have no sense of what they even want to be when they grow up.
And one of the things that has been mentioned is that you've been changing the way young people relate to their bodies.
That would be a nice thing. I mean, that's a nice compliment.
But do you agree? Is that a part of your project?
I think a part of my project is that I think that the way that the media talks about women's bodies particularly is really problematic. And if I can be in any way a part of reversing that, I would be happy. Thank you.
Many would call it brave. Is it brave? Do you feel brave when you do it?
No, I mean, there's lots of things that would be. I would feel brave if I drove a car.
I'd feel brave if I was almost naked.
So we could just trade and we'd both be so brave. But I think that, you know, for me, I think when people say that it's brave, that's not something that they're going to say to an actress who fits their sense of what a woman who should be on television looks like. You know, it's a compliment. That's actually sort of an insult. So That's one to parse through. But I don't feel...
I didn't mean it that way.
No, I know you didn't. No, you said some people say. You didn't
I
stood out of it like a good...
I did. But also because I'm the father of... I have two daughters, and I want to thank you because it's so important what you're saying to them.
That means so much to me. Thank you.
So, but really...
Thank you. Yeah, how old are they?
I have three daughters, but one is just 2 years old, so it's a bit early for her to watch your show.
No, we don't even know what she's going to be about. We have no idea. She might be a lesbian.
Might be.
That'd be great.
That would be, absolutely. But it's, I have one here, she's 18, and one 22.
Oh, yeah,
and they're watching
that's
girls.
Great. That makes me happy. Thank you.
With
Do you
their
watch
mother,
it with...
actually. That's more, I didn't know.
You don't watch it with them?
No, I don't. I watch it alone. No, but I've been watching it, but as it happens, alone. Because they're embarrassed to watch it with me, so they ask me to leave.
They ask you to leave?
Yeah, because, obviously, because of you don't want to watch naked people with your parents.
No. Nope. I've made that mistake before. That.
You've done it.
Yeah, I've watched my show with my parents. That's ultra horrible. They're cooler about it than I am. They're just like sitting there like it's a regular TV show, and I'm like, oh my God.
But your parents are not like all parents. They're artists.
Mm-hmm.
And your father, he's actually got an exhibition in Oslo now.
He does. He has an exhibition.
Yes, I've seen it.
You have?
Yes, he's great. But it's also quite explicit.
Yes, it is.
As his pictures are.
Yes, I can't even say on television what it's about.
No.
But I love that. My dad has this whole kind of fun life in Oslo. I went once, but my sister's been a bunch of times. My dad has all these cool Norwegian friends, and it's like in Norway, he's a real cool guy. Who knew?
Well, what kind of child were you?
What kind of child were you?
More or less like I'm now.
That sounds amazing.
Yes, well, I was amazing. No, I was a bit too grown up to be a child, in my own view.
I think I felt the same way. I think I felt both immature, because I never wanted to be apart from my parents or leave my house, but also deeply mature, because I had no interest in speaking to other children, and as a result, they had no interest in speaking to me, which then hurt my feelings. It was a very vicious cycle. I wouldn't say that childhood was, I think, the most pleasurable period of my life. I like being an adult better.
In your book, you write about being afraid of almost everything.
Yeah.
You had problems sleeping.
Yes. In my book, I talk about the fact that I had a lot of anxiety around sleeping from a young age. So when I was a little kid, I was, like, terrified and constantly going into my parents' bed and displacing them and waking them up. And because I didn't understand, and it's confusing for a kid, what is the difference between sleeping and being dead? I couldn't figure it out. I kind of still can't figure it out, but now I like sleeping enough that I'm not asking questions. But the difference still isn't totally clear to me.
You got help. You got the diagnosed, like OCD?
Oh, yes. What did you call it?
Diagnosed?
Oh, diagnosed. I thought you were saying like a cool Scandinavian word for OCD that I could bring back to the United States.
No. Let's clear this. I'm sorry.
I loved it.
No, it's my accent.
It's very... Don't change it.
I can't change it. I mean, even if I would. OCD is obsessive compulsive disorder.
You've got it.
No, I haven't got... Nope. Well, my mind... But it's actually, we shouldn't joke about it because it's quite serious.
It is serious. I feel like I'm allowed to joke about it because I feel like we're all allowed to joke about the illnesses that we personally have.
I agree.
It's part
I
of how
can't
you can get through
it.
Life, but no, you can't joke, I can joke about it.
Explain, how was that for you? I mean,
it's obsessive compulsive disorder manifests really differently for different people. So there's no sort of, it's not like a disease with a fixed set of symptoms. It can be a lot of different things. For me, it was a lot of counting and checking on things in my house to make sure that they were safe and just generally sort of, you know, casing the joint, a lot of disruptive, obsessive, looping thoughts. And then it's just something that there are therapists who can talk to you about it. And then there's a website. If anyone out there thinks they have obsessive compulsive disorder, you can go to ocfoundation.org, and there's a lot of resources. And I remember, it's actually where I went as a teenager to sort of look up information that made me feel more normal.
Living the adult life with, I mean, in a relationship, as you are now, as I understand, mm-hmm. does that make you...
I have a boyfriend,
you...
big news for everyone. I do have a boyfriend.
Very nice.
It doesn't mean that this isn't real, but I do have a boyfriend.
And what a shame. Now it's okay to tell him.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah.
I feel comfortable. I don't want to string him along for too long.
Does that make you a different person, being a part of a relationship? Does that change you?
I think it's really nice to have somebody who supports you and loves you and is connected to every aspect of your life. But I think in the best relationships, you remain yourself. You just have a more pleasant ride of it.
What about you?
Yeah, I think that's right. You should, if you're not remaining yourself, you are not the person the other person loved anyway. So
you haven't changed a bit.
Well, I smell less than I used to since that. But I still.
Are you married?
We're not actually married, but we've lived together for 12 years now.
That's awesome.
But I think actually we're in some ways, not being married is part of the excitement.
Yeah,
because she could leave at any time, very easily. There's no legal ties, there's no awkward stuff about joint bank accounts or anything.
No, so you're choosing to be together every day.
Exactly. We don't have any children either, so we're only together because we want to be.
Which is really fun and romantic.
In fact, we've got, because I don't want to give too much away, but when we met, I just bought a house and Sarah had just bought a flat. But now we both live in the house because it's bigger. But we've still got the flat and technically that's hers. And technically, because I bought it by myself, the house is mine, so... She might be gone when I get home at the end of the day. Especially if
that's
she's
part
listening.
Of the excitement,
that's
right?
Great.
Well, it is.
Would you prefer that model? Do you think that's for you, or are you the marrying type?
I personally don't want to get married until it's possible for everyone, no matter their sexuality, to get married all over the United States. So I don't have an interest in doing that.
So that's what you're waiting for.
Yeah.
But when that's possible, will you marry then?
Oh, probably. I mean, why not? Try everything. But it's not like, I was not the person who grew up being like, I can't wait for my wedding. I mean, weddings are lovely. It's a great excuse to dance and eat food and scream at people, but...
But then you have to be married.
Then you have to be married. Although, maybe, I have a feeling we might find, were we to get married, that living full-time with someone and dealing with every bit of their nonsense is not that different than being married. Everyone's always like, it changes, man. You're gonna feel it when you're married. I'm like, okay. Whatever you say.
Lena, it's wonderful to have you on the show. Good
it's
luck with your book.
It's a true pleasure.
And please
I really like
hang around
your energy.
A bit because we're gonna have some other guests. What did you say?
So I really like your energy.
My energy?
It's very positive. Same with yours.
Thank you. I was gonna say I really like your hair. Actually.
Oh my God, thank you. This has been a new... I went green about a week and a half ago, and it's been a whole new lease on life.
I was not mentioning it because you also have a very strong energy, so I didn't see it. But I see it now. It's green.
It's green. I like the idea that you just thought, like, sometimes there's blonde girls, sometimes there's green-haired girls.
Lena, I know that you have to leave us because you're busy with another engagement, right?
I've got some stuff with the Queen.
And it's the Queen, after all.
Yeah, several queens actually getting together.
It's been so great to have you on
the
show.
Thank you, what a pleasure.
And thank you so much.
Thank you.
Please, let's give him a proper welcome. Oh. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.